Hello and welcome to a Battlefield 4 commentary. I'm Itz Gyro. I will be your commentator for the day. We are going to be playing some TDM on Operation Locker on the Xbox 360. I'm running the AK-12, which is the default assault rifle for the assault class. I think this gun is great. Obviously, I'm using a USAS at the moment, but it's the gun that I picked up off the ground that's on the map. Frag rounds with the USAS. That was like the beastly combo in Battlefield 3 whenever the game first came out. I'm running a 3.4 times scope with laser sight, suppressor, and I think the ergo grip for the AK-12. Running it also in two-shot burst, and this gun is just amazing. I would have to say that this gun is really amazing. But be warned, everybody, they will be patching all of these guns or changing around the attachments like they did in Battlefield 3. And it's going to make all the great guns maybe not so great in the future. So, you know, who knows? I thought that they would have already, you know, pretty much nerfed this gun from the beta. But it's pretty much the same as it was before, except for you just can't handle it in full auto at range very well. So that's why I like that two-shot burst. It's very, very nasty, so... So my very first thoughts on Battlefield 4 as a game is it's a great game. Very great. I'm going to have lots of fun with it. There is a lot of unlocks. I mean, just insane amount of unlocks, insane amount of guns. Lots of leveling up to do. There's also the commander mode, which is not so much fun in theory or just in playing it. It's kind of boring, but it does get you points. I will talk more a bit about commander mode in a minute. But let's talk about the game itself on console, which is Xbox 360 and PS3, and then PC. Now, I own Battlefield 4 on PC and Xbox 360. I bought it on Xbox 360 because I found out that your stats will transfer over to the brand new systems once they come out. So I didn't want to be left hanging, being a noob, being a level 1 whenever the brand new system comes out. So I'll just trade it in for the 360 version. And then pick it up for the Xbox One version whenever Xbox One comes out November 22nd. Not too long away from that either. So I would definitely say, of course, Battlefield 4 is so much better on PC than it is on Xbox 360. I would just say that the 360 version can barely handle the game, let alone make it look well, as you guys can see from the mediocre graphics here. This is, of course, console. Another thing is that the Xbox 360 version does not have a spectator mode. The PC version has a spectator mode. Now, I hope that the brand new systems have a spectator mode, because I probably assume that the 360 just can't handle a spectator mode, for the simple fact is the game can barely handle 24 people, let alone 24 people with other people watching the game. Hey, look, guy just sitting in a corner. You're dead. So I definitely say, if you have a PC that can run Battlefield 4, which mine can just barely even run it, let alone record any or do anything on it other than maybe cinematics by myself in a lobby with nobody else. So say definitely get it on PC over Xbox 360 or PC or PS3 if possible. Whenever it comes out on the brand new systems, I will of course let you guys know how it is on Xbox One. I will be picking up a PS4, but that'll probably be a few months later, because I just don't have a grand to be dropping into some game systems at the moment, and also I kind of want to get my PC better, so who knows what will happen. But I definitely say that Battlefield 4 is going to fill my time with lots and lots of enjoyment. There's been a little bit of frustration here and there on the console version. There's a few maps that just freeze while loading, like Hannon Resort, which I hope I pronounced that correctly. If not, then excuse me. And then also Dawnbreaker. Anytime that I try to load those maps, 8 out of 10 times the game freezes and I have to reset my console. So, I mean, it's just such shit. I hope it is not like that in the brand new consoles, or I hope that they just fix it overall. Another thing that I wish that they would have put into the game for the console versions is a way to join with your friends. I bought a multiplayer game to not be able to join a game with my friends. There's no pregame lobby. So the only way for me to join games with my friends is for somebody to be in a game. And then everybody else has to join onto that person. But you know what happens 9 out of 10 times? That lobby fills up instantaneously. So we are SOL, which is shit out of luck. If you guys enjoyed, hit that like button. If not, tell me why. Peace.